The ketone meter is the sensor you'll use for the shortest amount of time. We only require it for the first 10 to 14 days of the program. However, collecting ketone data is important, particularly if you are currently taking insulin. To make sure your body has enough fuel, we need to make sure your diet helps you create ketones, just not too many ketones. Getting healthy is always a balancing act. Measuring your ketones will help us see where you are on any given day so we can give you nutrition guidance that helps you achieve an effective ketone level. The ketone meter comes in a zip pouch that holds the ketone meter, the lancing device, lancets, testing strips, and one calibration strip. This is all included in each batch of the ketone strips. When it's time to set up the ketone meter with your coach, you'll also want to have two AAA batteries, which you can go ahead and place in the meter now if you would like, or just before the call, and an alcohol wipe ready to go. Now let's talk about what you will do with your coach when you set up your ketone meter together. If you haven't already, you will put the two batteries in the ketone meter. Next, you will sync the ketone meter to the Twin app by opening the app and going to More, My Sensors, and then connect a new sensor. In the Twin app, you will see a ketone meter sensor icon appear. You will tap this icon and then tap Connect with Sensor. At this time, you will leave your app open and make sure it is near the meter. A message will appear to say the sync is complete. Press Done. The next step is to calibrate the ketone meter. Making sure the meter is off, locate the control strip that is attached to the strip of the test strips. Insert the control strip into the top of the device, ensuring that the numbers on the control strip and the orange button are both facing you. Once inserted, the device will turn on and begin to calibrate. Once complete, you'll see a number on the screen that matches the number on the control strip. Your device is now ready for your first reading. Plan to measure your ketones every morning on an empty stomach or as directed by your twin care team. It helps to alternate the finger that you test on. For example, if you are right-handed, start with your left pinky finger on the first day and cycle through all the fingers before returning to the pinky. That will keep any one finger from getting too sore while the test finger is only tender for a few minutes or two afterwards. Performing the test on the fleshy side avoids any discomfort on the flat surface you use the most. Here's how you will take your first reading. Open the Twin app on your smartphone, lay open your case in front of you and wash your hands. Select the lancing device and remove the top by turning it counterclockwise. Insert a lancet into the slot so the round lancet safety cover remains visible. Push the lancet down to secure it, twist the safety cover off to expose the lancet point, and carefully return the top to the device. Pull the clocking control at the opposite end of the lancing device until it clicks. Note that the button window is now green. Note the numbered settings suggested by turning the upper part of the top. Adjust as needed depending upon the thickness of your skin. This may take some trial and error, but most people set it between 4 and 6. The higher the number, the deeper the prick. Open a test strip package and remove it. Hold it on the sides and avoid touching either end. Insert the end of the strip with the contact bars into the meter to turn it on. The single absorbent end of the strip is exposed. Wait for the meter to display a blinking blood drop. If the meter turns off before you can do the test, just push the orange button and wait for it to be ready again. Give your hand a shake and massage the tip of the finger you've selected. This brings blood to the area. Clean the spot with an alcohol wipe. For some, a finger prick is a little intimidating. Take a breath, you can do this. Place the tip of the lancing device against the fleshy side of your finger and push the button. Squeeze your finger near the site without touching the blood to help perform a generous pinhead-sized amount of blood. Place the absorbent hole at the end of the test strip at a tilted angle up to the blood drop. Hold in place until the meter beeps, about 10 seconds. Your ketone level will appear on the device screen. Make sure your Twin app is still open. Slide the eject button on the side of the meter to eject the testing strip. This will start the syncing process so your result is transmitted to the Twin app. Your ketone level will appear in the Twin app. Tap Log. Remove the lancet device top and use the eject button, a sliding bar on the side of the lancing device to eject the lancet. Carefully place it in a glass or plastic container for safe disposal. Return to the top of the lancet device and you're done. If your ketone measurement hasn't been added to the Twin app after a short wait, enter your reading manually. Tap on Help in the Measure Ketones action card, and then select Sync is not working today, and follow the instructions for manually entering your ketone reading. Lancets are for single use only. Store your used lancets in a recycled jar or plastic container. When full, dispose safely. When you're finished, store the ketone meter box and owner's manual in the Twin toolbox for safekeeping.